It's Jimmy Delrin today! What's up, my guy?
What's up, baby?
Let's go! Logan.
What are those?
Let's do a foot race.
A new body.
They're mellow.
Dude. What a one. Look at you.
Alright, you guys tell me where to stop, okay?
They're comfy. They're like the only shoes I buy.
Not from here. You must not be from here.
I'm from your mama.
Oh my goodness.
Up and welcome back to the channel, everybody. It's freaking hot out here, but we are out here at Ice Cream Cruise day one. There'll be several videos coming out about Ice Cream Cruise, but tonight this video is just about our Friday night racing. So we are in the Friday night truck class. Well, I think it's a truck SUV class. We are racing in that, and I think there's 16 some trucks, maybe a little bit more, but we're already all teched in, ready to go. I got spark plugs right here because Stuart told me I needed spark plugs, so I got spark plugs. I remembered a spark plug socket, so he's back there with Mike, and they are taking spark plugs out of the truck right now. There's London. London's all pumped. Scarlett, we're out here racing. It'll be a good time, so we're going to get down to gapping these spark plugs, and we'll go up for driver's meeting, see who we get, and then we'll go racing.
Good!
Logan!
Yeah.
What the hell, dude?
Battery's dead.
What the heck?
Start.
Eat the
dry cell.
Eat the dry cell. Everybody type in the comments dry cell.
Still dead.
With the owner of the black F-350 in staging lane number 2. All right, there you are. Hey, I didn't have to do my job. Thank you.
Is it countdown?
Yeah.
Believe it or not, hey, did you know that you can go to MrEZS10.com and get these shirts for like super cheap? It's crazy.
Maybe, it maybe remind me to turn the battery off.
Yeah. Yeah, guys, go get a shirt. It'll help us shut the truck off.
We were running the fans because we did 2-3 trans brakes in a row, and it was just fucking cooking.
Sheesh.
So I left the fans running a little longer than.
Obviously, we're behind.
Well, now you know I need a dry cell.
But hey, we're moving forward.
Buy 50 shirts and we'll buy a dry cell.
I can get you one for cheap.
Yay, party, yep. Woo. 50 shirts worth. Let's say. This thing doesn't have like a boost feature or something?
I think it's on the boost feature.
It keeps fucking going down.
Well, that's a counter.
Oh, it's a countdown. I was like, Jesus. Yeah. Good time. Got lots of racers out here. Got Test and Tune running. We're the fourth class to go up. So we drew I'm not even sure. It's a small pickup, something foreign with a flatbed on it, something like that. I guess Logan knows them. but we gotta get this thing started, do a two-step check. Like that, but a successful one. Be right back with you guys. All right, two-step check. We'll try that first round. Yeah. See how that goes.
I mean, that's a really hot fucking turn up still in it, you know.
Yeah.
There you go.
I think it'll last. What you got going? What do you think? Is it gonna go?
Yep.
It's gonna go. It'll be alright. It'll be alright. Alright, some of you guys might know this car and our buddy Kyle. New reversion of this whole car, right? New motor, new tranny, you got all kinds of new stuff. This is gonna be your first pass on the on this whole setup, right?
Second
technically. So yeah, we're rooting for you. Be safe, alright? Electric. He's got the Mustang. Oh, look at this Subi. This is freaking sweet. Look at this thing. Oh, looks like it's got that like war green. Fucking battle Subi right here. Sheesh. Yes, sir. Yeah. Don't know where Kyle is, but he'll be back here soon. S10, ready to go. She's good. She's golden. Oh, that's, milk money. It's, actually, this car's actually went pretty viral. It was at the 1320 underground meet. We got a little bit of that. Jesus. That's crazy. That is a badass van. right, buddy. What happened?
I don't know.
What do you mean?
Get the rocker away from me.
Get away!
I don't know. Push the oil out the catch can.
Dang it. All right, break it down.
Oh,
what do you got? What do you got? What do you got? What do you got?
The red lights on.
To this year's event, it started off a little rough with a power outage, but we're getting into our Friday night race.
All right.
I'm so excited you guys are all beat. You guys are all here.
What's that?
Oil. The warm-up party. Let's give a big round of applause.
What you got
Come
going?
Let's go.
What's up with this thing?
Racing, the car show.
Oh God, don't give me that look. Please don't tell me O2 sensor.
Let's party.
Go ask him how much tire pressure is in the tires.
Where is he at?
Just go fucking ask him.
All right, how much tire pressure is in the tires?
18. There's 18, see look. 31.5.
Holy sheep.
It
Are
me.
You serious?
He's blaming the old lady.
No. You had 31 pounds? Oh my God.
First thing he does, he's like, that's the wife. That's the wife.
Okay, in my defense, he said, how much is in there? And I said, 30.5. I said, how much do you want in there? He said, check the other one. And I said, there was 30. And
Holy.
I said, so how much do you want in there? And he said, put 30 pounds.
Bro!
Dirty in there.
Golly!
Yeah, I need a warm to sit in.
So I said, there's 30 pounds.
Yeah, the burnout tune in it.
Ketchup bottle.
Oh no, he has already had his burger for me.
See, that's the settings you want for that little concrete box area over there.
I already had to go rescue him.
Yeah, he told me.
Hey, if you need somebody, he finds somebody needs an entry ticket, I have one of those.
Entry for what?
For the whole weekend.
He got a quad out there.
Oh, like
a
spectator. Okay.
What did I say? It's your fault. You take that dirty bullet on there.
31 pounds.
I don't want to change nothing.
No, I don't. I'm thinking we need to change my shock settings.
Have you changed your shock settings before I set them up?
No.
Okay, well, so then we got to do something
else. I did the bar adjustment.
So the bar adjustment's done?
The bar adjustment's done. But he had 30 pounds of pressure at the time.
Do we redo the bar adjustment or see what it does? What did it do the first pass?
Terrible. It blew its tire.
Oh, yeah. Right off the
Oh, I bet.
It didn't even try to hook.
Oh, dude, 31 pounds, dude. Fuck.
Fuck, I haven't run radios for so long.
That's crazy.
I don't even know what the fuck went on.
31 pounds. Holy. We got a rookie over here.
The first race is like the first pancake. It's always a little weird.
Yeah. Not exactly what you want, but it's all right.
Yes,
you know, sarcasm.
Well, the first one's always a little weird, so that means the other ones are going to get better.
You want it to separate?
Yes.
Try the 18 in the tires. And just do what you just did, but it was 18 in the tires. I don't know. You fucking weird
bitch. Yeah, that's crazy. That's crazy to me.
Weird separate. I can't believe you just told her. Yeah, whatever's in them.
Well, 31 pounds.
Go straight first.
Alright.
Can't go straight while it's spinning.
Bill gathers it up. And
yep.
On the big end.
Do another test.
Tom Dixon goes 570, 142 miles an hour.
Well, they're telling times, too, huh?
Oh, yeah, tonight's all times.
Tom Dixon goes 007 on the tree.
Oh. 007 on the tree.
Little here and a there.
All right.
Everywhere.
Getting ready. Good.
Classic matchup.
Fairly confident in this tune up. It's hot, but the track's pretty good. Nobody's spun yet. So. I'll hit the 360 when you get up there.
64. At
All right, so we got round one, truck tailgate class, SUV class, coming up.
Look out, look out, look out.
That motherfucker. Left lane took it though. That's crazy to me. That was crazy. Alright, then you got first gen Ford Ranger, or it looks like a F100 maybe, against crew cab two wheel drive Chevy Vortec Max. Pretty bad fucking units here. happened.
I think he passed me.
He was in front. Oh, here goes Banstra. No, you're just fine. I'm recording about right here. First round, let's go.
Fuck yeah.
That's what I'm talking about. All right, now we got Nate Stoops, Poverty Row, coming up for a pass. Again, I think it might be another Poverty Row. I'm not 100% certain on that. Damn! Woo! first round.
Well, that didn't really go planned how we had it planned. The truck left really good. Did a really good pass, I guess. We'll see here. It did a 139.60 foot and a 384 to the 330, but then I lost 3 mile an hour by the eighth, and he finally come around with me. He got me by 0.066 wind margin. So he come around me, I treat him, but the truck just felt like it was spinning, but it wasn't. Come back to find out that our converter is a little bit on the looser side. We know this, but it was just blowing through the converter. So we did some changes. We're gonna hit it just a little bit harder in the 60 foot. We're gonna hit it a little bit harder in the 60 foot and leave the power out the back how we want it and see if it's gonna stick or not. If it blows through the converter, Stuart and I, maybe during the car wash, might do the car show. Might do a converter change. So yeah, we're figuring out what's gonna happen and we'll go from there. We are cooling it down. We are going to go do another test and tune pass, so we'll be able to find out what the truck does and how it acts. So we left the same amount of boost in it. I guess if it starts slipping, then we'll go from there. But yeah, we're cooling down, getting ready to go for a test pass. It's wild out here. The pack stands are packed both for the racetrack and the burnout buck. Pad. There's just so many people everywhere. You can barely get up to the lines. That's crazy good though. It's awesome seeing all the fans out. We're selling merch like crazy. Brooke just sold another shirt. So yeah, we're getting it going. But yeah, the truck is cooling down and we'll get ready to go and do another pass. So hopefully it's a little bit better. If not, we might do a fluid change tomorrow during the car show. It is what it is.
Julian.
She was going, holy crap. That thing did two or three wheelies on that thing.
Right. Remain because the oil is going to be
up. It's going to
suck it
up.
Look
at that Del Sol down here. I haven't seen one of them in a while. Man, that's a Del Sol, dude. I haven't seen one since like 1998. I got a Mustang with painter's tape on the back. Come on, you got to be proud of that rubber. What kind of pass are you going to run?
5.5.
Yeah, that's the number right there. You'll get it, buddy.
I don't know, let's reset this jack it back up and start it, I guess. I don't fucking know.
We got a Corvette. We got afterburner down here.
It's like not on the flex plate. That's what
I don't
think it's a main. But I mean, it's on the fucking starter.
Yeah. Looking good as always.
It's flinging on the starter. Like, call your head up over here. You can see it.
We got an all-wheel drive Jeep. No, is that all-wheel drive? That's rear-wheel drive. Converted. Well, two-wheel drive.
Not.
Grand Cherokee, young car with a hero in its name. What kind of pass are you going to make right now?
Over first.
Well, it'd only be on the one side of the
road. Are you racing them all in the 7.5 class?
Which is probably
the
side.
Yeah, well, I'll be racing them in the truck,
fucking,
good luck tomorrow, man.
I don't fucking know. I mean, there was a lot of drippage, but I mean, it wasn't fucking bad. I don't know, did we fucking tighten the fucking
check in his pan bolts?
Well, I think we need to reposition this jack because this jack's about ready to fall.
Oh, you got the air pressure going. What are you setting it at? 15.5, huh? What kind of pass are you going to make right now?
490.
490? How much that out there?
It's the next morning. We are setting up for the show, and I didn't do a really much of an outro besides them saying that I oiled the truck down last night. So we did jack the truck up. We did see oil. It wasn't like an alarming amount. It's coming like kind of off the back of the oil pan rear cover area. So we jacked it up, we checked the oil pan bolts, like six of the back bolts were pretty loose. I mean, we could put, you know, a turn or two into each bolt. I'm not sure if that was the cause. We did clean it all up and got it on the trans brake a couple times. We also did drive it around in the pits a little bit, kind of like trying to put a load on it, you know, hitting the gas and the brakes at the same time, trying to put a load on it, and it didn't start leaking again. And then also we, as it was all cleaned up, we left it in the trailer overnight, and this morning there was no oil on the floor of the trailer. So we come over here and we're getting ready for the show today. We're all set up, and Stuart drove the truck over here, let it run for, you know, 30 minutes or so, driving it over here and parking and stuff, and it's not leaking. So I don't know exactly what the scenario is. I don't know if, you know, making a pass on the thing will maybe make it start leaking or not, but yeah, we'll figure something out, and we'll get it from there. I'm supposed to be racing small tire tonight, but with this how it is, I think I'm gonna have to sit that one out. But yep, make sure you guys stay tuned to next week's video, because day two of Ice Cream Cruise will be out. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and be looking for the video to drop, because there is a bunch of sweet stuff going on here. I'm gonna try sneaking away from the booth and getting some videos. So I guess if you guys are here at Ice Cream Cruise, you might kind of know what is here. But if you guys are not, I'm gonna try showing you to the best of my ability. Mason might show up as well, might steal a camera from me and go do his thing with the camera. So we don't know exactly, but we'll figure something out. But yeah, stay tuned, because day two of Ice Cream Cruise is coming next week, 4:30 on Sunday. Like it. Me out.